Hi, I'm not a farm girl. I'm a brand new beekeeper. And today I'm going to show you our hives and talk a little bit about the parts of the hive. The beehive is the home for the bees. We're going to work our way top to bottom on this hive. This is a Langstroth hive. It was patented in the 1850s. It's the typical hive that you will see here in the Americas. However, there are lots of other kind of hives available. And in fact, when I was in Nicaragua, I saw these really cool hives just made in hollow logs on a coffee plantation. I'll try and find, I took some video of that and we'll try to slip that in here so you can see it. So let's go back to our hive. This is the telescoping cover because it slips down over the outside of the hive. This is the inner lid of the beehive. The bees use propolis to seal all the cracks and holes throughout the beehive. If this lid were on without the inner lid, if the telescoping cover was on, and they sealed this, it would be really hard to get your hive tool in there to pry it off because it would be sealed up here along this top edge underneath. Instead, the bees will seal just this inner lid, and that so that you can inspect. It also has a peek hole here so you can take a look at your bees if necessary. You can also put different kind of feed for the bees up here if necessary. The next part of the hive is the boxes. Now you'll notice there's a slight difference between this box and this hive. And that has to do with the number of frames which will fit inside. This is an 8-frame hive. The one below it is a 10-frame hive. You'll also see this box is shallower than this one. This is called a deep box. This is a medium. The only difference between the boxes once the hive is assembled, other than size, is what is going on inside of them. Typically, your bottom box on your hive is going to be your brood box. Brood box, brood is another name for babies, basically. So your brood box is going to be where the queen is laying her eggs. And then on top of that, once that box is full of everything that's going on in there, then you'll add what they call a honey super so that the bees can store their honey. Now, inside of each box, you're going to have frames. When you get your frames, they come empty. You can order them probably pre-assembled, but usually they'll come empty like this. This is called a frame. And obviously, why? It's just exactly what it sounds like. Then you order your foundations. The foundation is this part, which looks a little bit like honeycomb. Ours is made of wax. They're also available in plastic. And it's just what it sounds like. It's the foundation upon which the bees will build out their comb. We're going to make another video showing how we install the foundation in the frames. All right, and the last thing that I have to show you right now is the screened base. There's a pest that can harm your beehive called Varroa Mites, and the screened base is not for ventilation as I thought it was, but it's actually so that the mites will fall out. Sometimes, especially when you get a new package of bees, they're gonna need to be fed. They're gonna be a small colony and they won't be able to go out and forage right away. They have to spend their time growing the colony and getting their home ready, drying out all that comb on top of those foundations. And so we've also got a feeder. You make a mixture, a sugar water mixture, kind of a syrupy mixture. Screw it in here. You're gonna turn it over, and then it will fit onto the front of the beehive like so. And the bees are able to go inside here, eat the sugar mixture without ever exposing themselves to danger outside the hive. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a good day. What do you call it when you put the foundation in the frames? Install, thank you. Sorry. Sorry, you fell. And I'm not laughing because you fell. I'm laughing because I did this.
Is he going down?
Yeah, exactly. All right.